I going to live my life if I'm in this much pain all of the time? It never subsided. You're getting out of bed in the morning and you're in pain. Like, I don't know if I want to continue on if I'm going to be in pain constantly. It's just not worth it. And I mean, I tried everything to get out of the pain, and you want to get out of the pain so quickly. And now I look back and it's like, once I joined wealth, like, it's not that long of a time in the grand scheme of things. But when you're in pain and it's constant, it feels like it's your whole world.
I mean, you having suicidal thoughts?
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah. But for some of our members, when they say life-changing, like, that's what they mean. They meant that they were going to kill themselves. And then they found the relief and the strength through the program. And now they're not in pain when the medical assistant couldn't do that. Or life-changing in the sense that, you know, it wasn't about suicide or stopping living like that, but, you know, every other aspect. So thank you for sharing that.
I think the thing that I really like about wealth and doing the program is you guys really empower us to become our own healers. Like, learn the moves, heal yourself, right? Because we can. Whereas for a long time, I was outsourcing it. I was like, oh, hey, chiropractor, fix me. You know, doctor, fix me. Where with wealth, it's like, no, I'm actually going to heal myself. I'm going to fix myself from doing this program.
Well, Sarah, thank you so much for joining us on the Wealth Podcast. I appreciate having quick background. I think you and I first spoke in like August of 22 or August of 23 on the phone. And I'll let you dive into it. But from what I remember, you were in severe pain. I think you had it was an L4-L5 disc herniation or L5-S1 disc herniation.
Yeah. So I looked it up we first connected in August of 2022. So it's almost been my 2-year anniversary with Wealth and Limitless.
Let's go.
Let's go, guys.
That's awesome.
I'm still doing the program. I love it. People are like, do you work for Wealth? I'm like, no, I wish. Like, they're amazing. You
we'll
know,
hire
everybody,
you.
Yeah. Everybody needs to know about them. So yeah, I joined and I just looked up like my MRI. And so it was an L. So I had a lot going on. I had L3-L4 issue. I had an L4-L5 and I had an L5-S1.
Okay.
Yeah. So I had all of those going on. The biggest one was the L5-S1, and it was compressing on my nerve, which was causing sciatica. And so when I came to you, I couldn't stand. I'm standing now. I feel so good.
Hey, there we go.
I couldn't sit. I couldn't sleep. I wasn't sleeping. And I think that, I mean, all of it was having a huge effect on my mental health. But I feel like when you are not sleeping, you kind of start to lose it. And I am a very positive, upbeat, happy person. I can see the good in things, but I was in a really dark, negative place for a long time because I wasn't sleeping. I wasn't functioning. I was in pain constantly. Like, breathing was painful. Mm. And so, yeah, I found you after I was struggling for a long time. I started having issues in October.
Of 21, maybe.
Exactly.
Yeah. Right. Yeah. So about 10 months you had really bad sciatica. Okay.
Yeah.
Wow. Yeah. What was, and so 10 months you dealt with that. Yeah, I know you're saying like, I couldn't sit, I couldn't stand, I couldn't sleep. It's like, all right, what left is there to do? Maybe like lunge or hang or whatever. I don't know how else you've just.
When I had a call with Cameron, I was laying on my stomach.
Yes.
That was like my position. So before I found you guys, it's really interesting with back pain specifically. You feel isolated and you feel alone, but when you talk to people, everybody has a solution for back pain. Everybody is an expert on what you should do. So
yeah,
it started off slow. And so I was still doing things and I would tell people because I'm like an overshare, kind of like what's going on with me. Like, I like to connect with people. I'm very like real. And so I would tell them like, yeah, I'm dealing with this like really terrible back pain. And they're like, oh, I have a chiropractor. Oh, you know, you should get injections. Oh, you should try this. You should try that. And so I just started doing all of those things. And eventually none of them worked. And we talk about them if you want. Nothing worked until I found Wealth. And it got to a point where my husband was like, babe, I think you need to just like take a beat, take a pause. Like, you're trying all of these things, spending all of this money, right? And nothing's working. Like, why don't you just take a break, take a pause and see? And that is when I finally was like, okay, I'm not going to do anything. I'm just going to take a break. I was just chilling in my backyard all summer, just like reading, laying on my stomach because I couldn't do anything. I couldn't travel. And then that's when I found out about wealth. I was listening to a podcast in my backyard and I heard Andrew on a podcast talking about his journey. And I was like, oh, that makes a lot of sense. That's really cool.
What, I guess I have two questions from there. I know you said you spent a ton of money. This is from what I remember, I think on the last Instagram story you did of yourself, was it upwards of 20K or something that you tried spending on your back before? Oh my gosh. Over. Yeah. And was that in that 10-month period of pain?
Exactly. Yeah.
Yeah.
The thing that's so interesting about our medical system too, is like, I was going to doctors and they were like, oh, you can try this injection. And so I tried one. It didn't work. They said, you should try it again. And like, I was so desperate. And I think so many people are, when you're in pain, you're willing to try anything. So I was like, okay, I'll try it again. And then they're like, oh, that didn't work. Like, we can operate. And it's like really easy. It's so small, you know, you'll recover so quickly. And I'm like, I don't trust you. Like, I've tried all of these things that don't work and you keep telling me to try something else and that this is the solution. And I think the thing that I really like about wealth and doing the program is you guys really empower us to become our own healers, like learn the moves, heal yourself, right? Because we can. Whereas for a long time I was outsourcing it. I was like, oh, hey, chiropractor, fix me, you know, doctor, fix me. Where with wealth, it's like, no, I'm actually going to heal myself. I'm going to fix myself from doing this program.
Yeah. And I think what you're saying is probably going to lead me into the second question that I had, but just like when you listen to Andrew on that podcast, what resonated with you about wealth? And this is probably the entire essence of what we try to portray ourselves as, maybe what you're going to say.
Yeah. No pressure there.
Yeah. Right. Just teed you up.
Yeah. No, I'm like, what does Cameron want me to say? I'm not sure.
No. Yeah.
I mean, I really feel like Andrew was, taking his power back, you know, he was like, this is how I did it. And I think one of the biggest things that I really appreciate about Andrew is he's not afraid of pain.
Right.
And he really taught me that pain is nothing to fear, right? It's an indicator that, you know, we need to fix things, but we can actually work through the pain. We can exercise through the pain. And I think the reason that mine got so bad was because I got afraid to move. I started feeling this pain and I was like, oh, I don't want to break my back. I don't want to break myself. You know, I don't want to cause even more damage. Like, I'm damaged. And it's like, no, I'm not damaged. Right. My body is not in perfect alignment and there's work that needs to be done. And like, I actually can fix it. And I feel like that's what I was hearing him say is like, hey, healed this. Yeah.
Yeah, I did. I teed you up. I put a lot of pressure on that, but no, that's cool. I think there's a lot of different ways in which you can answer that. And I think, that's an awesome insight on pain and learning how to work with it. Because I think what it sounds like with, you know, a lot of the methods that you tried for 10 months, you're in a really dark and desperate place and you want to do anything really to almost probably take that pain away very quickly.
Yeah.
And then for a lot of instances, a lot of people, injections might not work, chiropractor, you know, massage, like those things just alone while not solving the root problem, like most times do not work. So then you come to wealth and it's kind of, hey, this pain, I understand it sucks. It's not a fun situation to be in. However, we can like not fear it, but actually work with it. And once we start to at least drop our guard down a little bit on being fearful of it, like, yes, it really hurts, but then being more fearful of it, more scared to move. If we're able to take those signals with, you know, appropriate instruction and movements and workouts and guidance and support, then we can really start to heal, I think, in a physical and mental way as well. Because I, you know, the mental component, when you have sciatica, I had that too for about as long as you did. And that was really tough mentally for me. What were some of the, like, I'm sure people with injury, what were some of the lowest or darkest times or thoughts or experiences that you had within, you know, this 10 months?
Yeah, I think the main thing was just trying to figure out, like, how am I going to live my life if I'm in this much pain all of the time? So for me, it was, it never subsided. So, you know, you're getting out of bed in the morning and you're in pain and you're just kind of thinking about, how am I going to function? Like, you know, I'm in my 30s and I want to have kids. And it's like, how am I going to have kids? I'm like very active. How am I going to go for hikes? How am I going to travel? Like, I didn't travel for, you know, like half a year. And that's a long time. I feel like in our society now, there's like lots going on. We're moving, we're doing things. And so I think for me, it was just like, do I want to live a life where I can't do the things that I want to do? And now it's hard for me to think back to that because now I'm in such a different place and I'm so happy to be here. And it's hard to like go back to that. But right. I just remember being like, I don't know if I want to continue on if I'm going to be in pain constantly. It's just not worth it. And I mean, I tried everything to get out of the pain and you want to get out of the pain so quickly. And now I look back and it's like, once I joined Wealth, like it's not that long of a time in the grand scheme of things, but when you're in pain and it's constant, it feels like it's your whole world.
So, I mean, I know people say that figuratively and literally when you say that, I mean, you having suicidal thoughts.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah,
it's, that is such an intense thing. I personally never got to that place,
yeah,
but I can understand how people would. And I've had people tell me that on the phone, which is, you know, leading with the conversation of that, or they go through the program and they were like, the program was life-changing. And I think life-changing gets thrown out a lot, but for some of our members, when they say life-changing, like that's what they mean. They meant that they were going to kill themselves. And then they found the relief and the strength through the program. And now they're not in pain when the medical assistant couldn't do that, or life-changing in the sense that, you know, it wasn't about suicide or stopping living like that, but, you know, every other aspect. So thank you for sharing that. It's I feel like about as dark and tough as it can get with pain.
Yeah. Yeah. I remember I was going to, you know, this expert in San Diego who works on athletes, and you know, he was telling me about like different like pain pills I can take. And like, I think in my like Wealth reel, I said that I'm like a hippie, like natural person. And somebody's like, what does that mean? And what I mean by that is like, I don't take medication. I don't take medication for headaches. Like I just don't do that. And so he was like kind of telling me like, oh, here's like the cleanest options you can take. Just like try it. Like you're in so much pain. Like I can't even work on you. And I remember like trying it and it had no effect on me, like what he was recommending. And so I was just like, oh my gosh, like I'm never going to escape this pain. Right. And so I think that's when, you know, the suicidal thoughts come in where it's like, this is my reality and nobody can save me. You know what I mean? And I had also, you know, everybody's like, oh, why don't you just do surgery? Well, I'd also read about different case studies where people had surgery and they were worse off than before. And so I was like, oh, that is not an option. You know, like there's no way that this could get worse for me. Like I'm not going down that route.
Yeah. You're like, how did my thoughts get worse from this?
Exactly. Exactly.
Yeah. It's you know, this is an anecdote, but we have a gentleman who started in the program this week. He's actually a friend, a brother of a friend from high school. He's 2 years younger than me. So 26, 25, maybe. In January, he opted to not do Wealth. You know, I was trying to obviously push him, you know, I'm like, hey, I think this would be a great program for you, because he was deciding between back surgery and Wealth. So you got a microdiscectomy, and then 3 weeks later it re-herniated. So in 3 weeks he went back for a second surgery. You know, it's, maybe it really was warranted, but you know, for some surgeries, like risk of re-herniation is, heightened after that, you know, and there's different complications with surgery. And I think, again, there's place for that. But what we see with a lot of our members, and I believe we see very strongly in the medical system, is we're very quick to just throw you down that line of honestly very ineffective and not empowering tools. And like if four sessions of PT or 10 sessions doesn't work, or if the two injections don't work, or if this doesn't work, or the nerve block doesn't work, it's just kind of a linear path for people who want to stay on and get surgery. And I know a lot of people do not want to do that. And then I think it makes people feel like their pain is so unique, or they're failing, or it's a different situation, or that they'll never get better because we've thrown the kitchen sink. I mean, you threw $20,000 and a bunch of really smart people and things at your situation. So, you know, I have empathy for you. Like how I can understand why you would be like, it's never going to get better, which is funny. Then you come in and you're like, but wait, wealth is different. You know, like it is, I understand the irony of that as well. When people come to us and they're like, but what's different? And it's like, it's so different because it's so different than I think what you've done, which is it's not a magic pill. It's not, you know, so it's not a magic solution. So maybe, you know, we've been talking about this. We talk vaguely what Limitless is, but what would you say was different, or how would you kind of, you know, describe your experience, like starting the program a month in, 2 months in, 6 months in, like, what did that look like?
Yeah, I feel like I'm such a fan. And so I'm like, so happy to talk about this. But like you were saying, it's hard to wrap your head around it when you're not in the program yet. Because for me, what was really hard was I went to physical therapy, and my physical therapist was like, I don't know what to do with you. Like, you can't do these moves. Like, I don't know what to do with you. And so exactly like you were saying, it makes it seem like, oh, something's wrong with me. Like something is inherently wrong with me. I can't be fixed. And so then you see your guys' program and you're like, well, how is me doing these moves like on my own going to be better than me going to physical therapy?
With you know, it's like watching you.
Exactly. It's like, you
always say that.
Yeah. Your brain can't understand it at the time, but it's so much better. Like Limitless is so much better than physical therapy because like you're saying, you're doing the moves at home, so it's easier to actually fit them in. I love that the moves are simple and things that I can do no matter where I am. Like if I've been traveling, I still do Limitless while I'm traveling. There's no excuse not to do it. Where with physical therapy, it's like you have to actually go there, right? And with a lot of physical therapists, they're not specializing in like helping people get out of pain, which is what you guys are doing, right? So that was really cool. And I think one of the biggest reasons I ended up in this place is because I didn't have awareness around how my body works, how all of the pieces work. I didn't focus on really understanding where I feel like Wealth and Limitless is very educational. So I've learned a lot as well. I mean, I could keep going on like the community, like there's just so much stuff. And it's like you're saying, like, I wish all of the people who are in the medical space who are educated and helping people like knew about what you guys are doing, because it's so powerful and so helpful.
Yeah, it's really cool when you have people who like on Thursday we're interviewing a functional 39-year-old functional nurse practitioner. You know, she's been in that field for a long time, and she had a 12-millimeter disc herniation. She just went back, got a repeat MRI, dropped down to 5-millimeter, which is really cool to see a before and after MRI. But so I'm looking forward to kind of talking with her, because that's what she was saying. You know, there are some horrible pitfalls of the medical system that make people feel like it's not working. And it's like, hey, like, let's, I mean, there's so much to unpack there, but you know, when you go to a PT who just is not factually great at doing their job, or young or whatever, you know, everyone needs to gain experience, but, you know, you go to some sort of PT who can't help you, then you feel like you're broken. And then you kind of toss that entire PT bucket out. So people would be like, well, why would I do wealth? Like PT doesn't work. So maybe what I want to ask you is like, what were some big takeaways that you learned, let's just say like movement wise, or things that you learned about with your body through the program that were very insightful and beneficial?
Yeah. Okay. Wait. So I want to kind of circle back to PT really quick, because I think that another thing that makes wealth so different is you guys are so like, this is what you're supposed to be doing. Like, it's very clear that this is the work you guys are supposed to be doing right now, where I feel like sometimes you go to like an expert in another field. And like, that's what, cause for me, like I am a researcher, like I'm going to like the best PT I can afford. So it's not like these people are new, but I think sometimes people get into jobs or work that they've been doing for a long time and they're burnt out, they're not into it anymore, you know what I mean? Whereas I feel like the Wealth team, like you guys are so committed, like you, Cameron, you're like always like responding to like DMs, like you're asking good questions, like in the community. Andrew, he's like giving feedback on like everybody's exercises, and like when they're having like a hard time, he's pumping them up. Like, I just feel like that makes a really big difference too, that I just wanted to say, because, you know, it's not that all PTs are bad, but I do think it's important that the people who are helping you on your journey, like actually care about you and actually are invested in this work. And it's very clear that the whole Wealth team really cares about the people joining the program.
Yeah. Well, I appreciate you for acknowledging that. And I think, you know, it's always, it's, you know, I have this distinct memory of talking with you where I was when I was talking with you. And, you know, I just saw someone post in the Facebook group literally right before the podcast started, this lady that I talked to, you know, beginning of the year, and she was crying on the phone in a really dark place and was deciding if she wanted to do a microdiscectomy or the program. And she just posted saying 2 months pain-free after Wealth canceled my surgery. And it's like, I remember that. So, and the reason why I'm very excited and I love doing what I do is because, like, same thing I told you. I mean, I had sciatica, and it was just a few years before that I was not able to sleep or lift or do the things that I wanted to do. And we all went down the same path of being like, what's wrong with me? And then coming across something that actually allows you to get out of pain. So that's kind of where, you know, I end up where I'm at. And so it always excites me, and it feels so purposeful to like see you get through this. So I think that's probably where you're picking up on that vibe.
Yeah. Yeah. I think probably like if somebody listens to all the, like the interviews that you do, like that will come through. It's very clear that you, like, you care about the people. And again, not saying that other people don't care, but you can feel the difference. Like when you've worked with a lot of people, like you can tell. And so I think that is a big part of the reason why this program works, is because like you guys actually are invested and you care about your students. Okay, but back to what I learned.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
What did I learn? I feel like I am, before joining the program, I didn't know a lot. So I feel like I mentioned this before. If you look at Wealth's Instagram, it kind of seems like you guys are all like bodybuilders, you guys are in the gym, like you guys are strong, and like I'm strong too, but I'm not going to the gym. Like I don't know what any moves are. Like I don't know the names of the moves, like anything like that. So coming in, it's like I'm learning like cars. I didn't know what cars were. Hip cars, shoulder cars, you know what I mean? Like, and those, they feel so good. They're like amazing for the body, you know? So I feel like I'm really learning about mobility. And I think the thing that is really cool is you can join Wealth and you can know very little like myself, or you can know a lot. And there's so many ways to kind of modify the program. So like now I'm doing the program still like 2 years, but I'm adding more weights, right? Like I'm like working on pull-ups. Like I can do, like I'm getting super strong. I can do push-ups, you know? So for me, it was like learning a lot of the basics that I feel like maybe people who work out at gyms know. Like I've never had a gym membership. I don't think I ever will. Like I like going every once in a while with my friends, but like I prefer to do like yoga or running or hiking, you know what I mean?
Yeah. Thank you for bringing that up, because that was something I remembered you said, was that when you first looked at Wealth, there was a bit of an intimidation factor, just wondering if it were for you. And so, yeah, you weren't intimidated getting in. You felt like you were able to kind of balance that to where you were at.
Yeah, for sure. Okay. I feel like at first when I joined, I don't know if this is like helpful or good, or I don't know if you guys want people to know this, but when I first joined, like, because if you think about it, and you know, I don't know where people are listening, but I was in so much pain. I couldn't walk. I couldn't sit. I couldn't stand. I couldn't do all of these things. So then going into like this workout program, that's very intimidating because it's like, well, how am I going to, you see Andrew and Cameron and you guys are like so built. And it's like, how am I going to do that when like, I literally can't sit in a chair right now? Like, how is it going to work? Like, and so when I first started, the exercises, they were hard. Like the very simple hip switches, those were really hard for me.
Sure.
And I was talking to my husband, Peter, about it because I kind of have this thing where I forget like negative things that happen and I only remember the positive. You know, it's kind of, I think it's a superpower, but it can not be helpful when you're doing interviews and recalling the past.
Interesting.
So I was asking him. Yeah, I was asking him about it. I was like, how was it at the beginning? I remember like having to ice after doing like module one and like the really simple exercise. He's like, you were really frustrated. He was right. Like, you were really frustrated at the beginning because you joined this program, you invested in this program, and like you're having a hard time doing these exercises.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But you know, I just kept going and it did get better. Like slowly over time, your body can do more. You have more range of motion. You have less pain. You feel stronger, right? I remember when I first started, I couldn't do like the half Turkish get-ups. And so Peter, like kind of my husband, he was helping me, you know, he had like this band that I would hold on and kind of take some of the weight off. And now I'm doing them with weights and it feels so
That's
great,
awesome.
You know, but it was definitely like a progression and it was frustrating at the beginning. But I think if I would have joined the program sooner, it wouldn't have been so bad, you know, in terms of me being able to move more and do more in the program.
Yeah. I mean, and I think honestly, most people are frustrated with the entire situation. I mean,
yeah.
I know I was, because you also, you know, you're comparing yourself to others probably, you know, and then you're comparing yourself to the old you. And then it's not like you necessarily want to be buying an online program to rehab. Like you would wish that you wouldn't have to be in that situation. And then furthermore, it's not like you necessarily want to do like these little fundamental things, but I think you have to figure out how you can tell yourself that you do want to do it, or even if you don't want to do it, that you need to do it. Which leads me into that question. When you were frustrated and still in pain, what was your mindset going through, or like why you needed to keep showing up for yourself every day?
Yeah, I felt like I didn't really have any other options. You know, it was kind of like, what am I going to do? Just like have a pity party here like all day? Like I've already done that. I've been feeling sorry for myself. I've been feeling frustrated. And I'm kind of the type where it's like, if I invest in something, I'm going to do it. I got to give it a shot. You know what I mean? Like, I read all of the testimonials. I talked to you, like I trusted you. So it's like, I've invested in this program. Like I owe it to myself. I owe it to the creators to actually give it a shot, you know? So it was like, I'm going to keep going. And the thing that is really great is it does come with community. And I love a community. I'm a big community person. And so anytime you're frustrated, you can post and be like, hey, I'm frustrated. This is what's going on. And somebody's going to be like, oh yeah, totally normal. I've been there before too. It gets better. Keep going.
Yeah. Just know you're not, I mean, I feel like a lot of what we do, especially with coaching, is just reassuring our members that they're not crazy, that it's not made up in their head, that their doubts are normal to feel, but it can and will get better if we just stick with it. And, you know, that's kind of where there's this little piece of like trust or just faith or hoping that you guys can trust us at Wealth when we're like, hey, I see for you, Sarah, that you're not out of pain. I understand it's tough, but like, this is where you can be if you keep doing it. So you almost have to have some sort of derive some sort of blind faith or trust, or for you. And I found the same thing with me. It wasn't for any other reason other than there's no other option. I think sometimes that's a good mindset to lock into as well, right?
Yeah, for sure. Exactly. It's like, it can only go up from here, right?
Yeah. Hopefully. And you know, yes, it went up from there, but also for you, like it took an immense amount of work. And when I say immense, I think that can be relative. You know, what would you say was the time commitment that it took for you to do the program, watch the videos, execute?
Well, at the beginning, it kind of took me some time because I told you, I didn't know how to do any of these moves. So I'm like studying them. I'm like, okay, how do I do this? I want to get it right. Like, you know, like I definitely have some of the perfectionist in me. But like once you learn the moves, it's quick, you know, like I can do a workout in like 30, 40 minutes, you know what I mean? And even the thing that I really like is, even if I don't do, now I know the program so well because I've done it so many times, like at least four times all the way through. Whoa. I can just kind of pick, I know. I mean, I might be someone who's done the program the most. I don't know for a fact, but.
You might be our biggest fan and referral. I think you've single-handedly, I think you might be now in double digits of getting your peers or people to join the program. So thank you for that.
Yeah, no, tomorrow we'll have you on the podcast and I feel like we'll share more because it's just, so I had back pain, right, and sciatica, but I have so many friends who have knee stuff, who have shoulder stuff. And like Peter, my husband, he does it with me. He didn't have back stuff, but he's really tall. And so he would have shoulder stuff. And so he's like, dude, the program is so good. Like I've like never had like such mobility in my shoulders. Like I don't have shoulder pain anymore. I'm like, it literally works for everything. Why wouldn't you do this? Like, why wouldn't you do the program? I don't know.
I think that's what's funny about like when I have a conversation with people and what they think they need. Like, I have to assure them that what they think they need, they're going to get. But it is a common situation in which, you know, someone like yourself comes in and, you know, what you need and what you think you need and what you want. Like, I get it. You don't want to have sciatica. So it's like, hey, I want the low back or sciatica treatment. And we're like, hey, you'll get that there. But then sometimes people are like, wait, why am I working on my shoulders? Or why am I working on the rest of the body? It's like, hey, just trust. It's all connected. Yeah. And then you come in, you're like, hey, I not only got rid of my sciatica, but everything else in my body feels better. And also, I worked on problems that I didn't even know that I had through this like one-stop shop program. So it is cool. You know, that obviously that's always pretty difficult to communicate until you feel it.
I see that in the community when people will join and they'll be like, can I just skip this? And I'm always like, do not skip it, you guys. Like, do not skip these moves. Like they're in there for a reason. And like, for me, it's kind of like, okay, you've been working on this specific area. Like for me, it started with like glute pain. And so I'm like, doing like the massager gun. I'm like having people work on my glutes. It's like, that's not working, right? Because like, that's not where it's originating from. You know what I mean? And so it's like, you've been working on the sciatic and back. Maybe you should try the shoulders. Maybe you should try some other things, you know?
Yeah, for sure. I mean, it definitely is not going to hurt to, when you're dealing with an injury, it definitely cannot hurt to increase the resilience and the strength and the mobility of the rest of the body, especially with neighboring areas. But I mean, really the entire body. And for that area where you're feeling pain, hey, by all means, start to learn about it, understand it. But I think a lot of people are very shocked when they start to realize like, oh, back pain, you know, here were three or five key takeaways. Sometimes our members have like, oh, it's these five things. And then some people are like, I can't really put my finger on it other than I was doing a lot of different things, not in the best way. And I cleaned them all up and now I feel better.
Yeah. Yeah, for sure. Yeah. I think for me, definitely just like having more awareness of my overall body and like how I'm functioning, because I work behind a computer, I'm on calls. And before this, I would kind of have this mindset of like, I need to like work out. And if after I work out, I can do like whatever I want, you know? So it's like go for a run and then I can sit for eight hours, you know? It's like sit all day for work and then I go to a yoga class and it's okay. Where now I'm like more aware since doing this program of how I'm functioning all throughout the day rather than 1 hour out of my 12-hour day.
Super interesting. So kind of like an awareness, but like movement snacks throughout the day, just like keeping the body feeling good and moving the entire time. Is that what you do now on a day-to-day basis?
Yeah, exactly. Like I kind of like to do, instead of like one long workout, I kind of like to do them throughout the day. So like walk in the morning, you know, like mobility exercises throughout the day. And then at the end of the day, I'll do like the limitless or weights or things like that. And again, it's not that I'm spending a lot of time. It's just like I'm hitting these things that make me feel really good.
And I think people would when you say 30 to 40 minutes for the Limitless program, if you could see what that payoff would be, I would think, I don't know the state of people's affairs and mindset and health, but I would feel like 99 out of 100 people would for sure put in 30 to 40 minutes to get rid of that pain. Of course, it's not as easy to just say it like that, you know, but of course your priorities change and what the time that you invest into these activities changes once you start to feel good. And I've personally found with myself, like, nothing could make me know the importance of the way in which I think about movement and actually move other than getting injured and going through it.
Yeah. Yeah. So sometimes that's like the wake up call that we need, right? Like to really value how we move. And this was definitely like, I've had other health challenges, but this one, like my back sciatica, was definitely like the most painful, the biggest wake up call, the most necessary. And I think I was talking to you, Cameron, a while ago, and you asked like, are you grateful for it, right? Like getting to a place. And I tell my clients that now too, because I think it's so powerful where it's like, you have to, once you're grateful that it happened, it's like, then it can leave you. Then you don't have to worry about it as much. Then it doesn't have as much weight on you. And so I feel like definitely I'm at the place with sciatica in my back where I am grateful that it happened. Like it taught me a lot. And like, I'm so glad, and I'm going to keep doing this program. I'm going to keep doing mobility now because of it. And if I didn't have it, I wouldn't be doing what I'm doing. I wouldn't be where I am.
For sure. I want to definitely hold that and ask you why you're grateful. And I think, you know, that would be a really big 30,000 foot view question. But I want to go back really quickly to when you were saying like, hey, 30 to 40 minutes, can you kind of give just like a general ballpark of like starting the program and then maybe a few different segments of the journey that you remember that were important, i.e. like, hey, my sciatica is gone, but maybe before that, like I'm working, I'm standing, like can you recount that?
Yeah, for sure. I would say like the first thing that I noticed, so I was somebody who would go to yoga classes, I would, you know, run, I would do all of these things. And then probably for like 4 months, I wasn't doing anything. And the first thing that I noticed when I signed up for the program and started doing some of the moves was my mental health. You know how we were talking about, you know, do I want to live, suicidal thoughts, like I'm so depressed. All of a sudden, my thoughts started getting better. And I was like, oh my gosh, like this is actually why I exercise, like for mental health, you know? Right. And so that was really cool to see that. I'm like, oh, I'm like seeing my life in a new light. I have a new outlook. Cool.
Okay. So the first thing was just like, even just some light, was it a mixture of like just light endorphins or endorphins, and then also just moving the body, getting a little blood flow, a little resistance, just going through something that's empowering and challenging as well.
Yeah. There's a lot of power, right? And doing something also, like feeling like, hey, I'm doing something to better myself. Like I'm taking responsibility for like where I'm at right now, right? That's very empowering. And so, that's going to improve your mental health. And so that was one of the first thing I noticed. I was like, oh, wow, like I missed this. This is great. Wow. So that was the first one. Another one. Yeah. Another one was sitting. Sitting, we really take that for granted, and it gets a bad rap. It's like, oh, people sit too much. But like, as soon as you can't sit without pain, you're like,
oh my gosh. Right. Cause like, you're like, you know, I want to go and travel. I want to go have a meal.
I want to drive out of my house. I want to watch Netflix. I want to take a bath. I want to like everything. Right. And so that was another point that was really exciting where it's like, oh, I can sit for longer without pain. Like, this is great. This is amazing. This opens up my world because, you know, you're like, oh, people spending 30 minutes to get out of pain. When you're in pain, like I was, your world becomes very small. You have nothing else going on. So it's like, you can afford to spend some time doing these exercises. And so that was the second thing I noticed. My options started to open up.
Oh, wow.
The things that I could do.
Yeah. Sometimes I hear people on the phone be like, I don't, like the time, I'm like, dude, you're in pain. All of these other like fun activities. I was talking to someone yesterday. She's like, I can't paddleboard or hike. And so we started talking about time commitment for the program. And I was like, you should use this time right now where you cannot do those fun things and just use this as an opportunity while you're in pain to devote time to the program so that when you feel better, now you have more options and time to do that. Like if you don't have time,
It's time. I honestly don't think it's really about the time. You know what I mean? Like it's not about the time because we make time for things that are important to us. I think that it's about fear, right? Mm-hmm. It's about, am I really going to be able to do this? Mm-hmm. Is this really going to work for me? Am I willing to let this go? Sometimes we get addicted to it. We get addicted to how people treat us, all the attention, right? And there's nothing wrong with that. It's fine. It's not like, oh, that's so bad. But it's just being aware of that. Because at the end of the day, like everybody can make time for this program.
Yeah. You just hit on so many things. You should come and sell the program for us. But, you know, yeah, you're so right. Some people are, they get so wrapped up. Like they are their diagnosis. And there is, at least when there's so much uncertainty or fear, there is a certain comfortability and certainty with, if I accept that my sciatica is going to just hold me down forever, at least I can't be wrong about another alternative. Like at least I can be right about this. Like if I just accept this is who I am, then I don't have anyone to blame or I don't have anything wrong with taking a chance so that maybe it is not the truth and maybe I do get out of pain.
I mean, it's complex because I think, you know, another thing that I noticed for me on like my healing journey, you know, at the beginning, it was like, oh, it's actually kind of nice to take a break from work. Like I was working all the time. I was like, it's kind of nice to like have a break for a second. When you're in really bad pain, you're like, okay, I'm over it. And, you know, but I think sometimes too, people are like, oh, like they need to make some changes in their life, you know? And so, and this is like allowing them to be in this space. But I think a reminder that, hey, you can get out of pain and live an even better life than you're currently living or that you were living before. Like life can get so much better than it was before the pain, in the pain. Like your future is so much brighter, but you do have to trust and do some of the work.
Yeah. Oh my gosh. Okay. So options opened up. So you're able to sit again. And then also you own your own business as well. I can imagine that when you were in pain, was that difficult? Were you still pushing through? Were you making less? Were you working less? What did that look like?
It was crazy. It was so crazy. I remember I was being interviewed. I got this interview with Forbes, which I was like so excited about. And I was like, oh, this is going to be awesome for our business. And I was really looking forward to it for a long time. And I'm doing the interview and it's a Zoom interview like this. And I have to sit. And so I'm just like in so much pain. And I finish the interview and I literally just like fall out of my chair. Oh, and it was like all of these things that I was really excited about were happening. My business was probably like at the peak, making the most money that I had made in like 8 years being an entrepreneur. And every time I would hit a milestone, I would just be like depressed. Wow. I'd be like, this literally means nothing because I feel terrible. And really, like they say, everybody says, it's so cliche, health is wealth, you know, but it's like, it's true.
Yeah.
When you don't have your health, like you don't have anything.
Yeah. Yep. I mean, and it's like, it sounds cheesy when people are like, when people are like, what's your company name? Like wealth, like how do you spell that? Like, oh, yeah. Your health is your wealth. And like people like kind of like, oh, that's cute, you know? But when you've been there, you really know it's
you
like,
get it.
It's no longer cute. Like, it's like, I mean that, you know, I'm willing to stand behind this name because, you know, it's like, if you have the financial capability like yourself to like spend $20,000 in 10 months on your health and that doesn't work. You're like, okay, like what if I had 200,000, I just kept going or 2 million or 2 billion, like no amount can do that. And you have to get aligned with like the right program and then also the right mindset. And then also like the right habits of you actually doing the work every single day. Mm-hmm. So yes, we're in agreement there. Did you have a third thing? Cause I know you said like mindset started to feel better. And then you said options started to open up, which is incredible, mm-hmm. right? That constricting view of pain, opening up your freedom to do things.
I mean, honestly, it's like everything. It's like sleeping through the night. Oh my gosh, sleep. I love sleep. Like, I'm like a Taurus. Like, I love like pleasure. I love sleep. And so not being able to sleep, I've always been a good sleeper too. Like in college, like I could sleep at parties. I could sleep on the school bus, on the airplane. Like, I'm good.
Yeah.
I could sleep through like fire alarms. And so not being able to sleep was like, what is this nonsense? This is not me. So that was really good. Sleeping through the night. It's amazing what 8 hours will do for you.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah. So that was good. And then, you know, like the sciatica going away, that, I mean, sciatica, like that, what is that? That is the worst feeling. Like, that should be illegal. That is the worst feeling I've ever felt. Like, I don't have kids yet.
Yeah.
I need to know from moms, but I feel like childbirth, like I could probably do it compared to sciatica. Like, oh my gosh. Oh, I have- yeah.
Yeah, it should be illegal. I had this member posted this story, or, you know, we worked on, you know, putting a story out, and he had been a professional dirt biker for a long time, and he's like, I've broken so many bones and had so many, you know, terrifying falls and instances, and he's like, nothing compares to that, you know. And I had same conversation with a ex D1 football player, and he's like, I've had so many horrible injuries and nothing compares to sciatica. So it makes me feel like, you know, with my background of just swimming in water polo, you know, I've never had any cool, you know, bone breaks as a kid, but I'm like, I got to imagine like the pain that I dealt was I'm like, I can't imagine something worse. You know, maybe there is something worse, and yeah. You know, everyone's pain is their own pain, so it all sucks in its own regard. But we should, maybe that'll be a tagline for 2025. Wealth is going to make sciatica illegal.
I love it. Yeah. Yeah. So that, I feel like that going away, that was huge. And then being able to travel again, you know, it's just like all your world is so small. And then all of a sudden it just slowly opens. And then you're grateful for everything, you know, like I just can't get upset anymore. Like, I remember, before I joined Wealth, I was traveling and I was on the plane and I could not wait to like get out of my seat. Right. And, you know, there's like this, there's people who, you know, as soon as the plane lands, everybody stands up. Right. And everybody, like, you know, like I have friends and family, they're like, why is everybody standing up? You know, like, it's so annoying. But like, when you're in pain, you're like, I got to get off this plane. Like, I got to get out of here. Right. And so fast forward to doing the program, traveling again, I'm just like sitting in my seat, the plane's taking forever. And I'm like, I'm cool. I'm good. Cause I feel good in my body. Like, I have nowhere to go. Like, this is amazing. Like, I'm not frustrated about little things that happen in life anymore. It's like, it's not worth it. You know, like, I get to live in a healthy body. Like, that's everything for me.
Yeah. And I think that's the biggest lesson that, you know, pain or an extreme challenge can teach you. And I think the health aspect of going through that, obviously it's like, hey, this body is what body and mind is what carries us through, you know, day-to-day operations and gives us, it can give us everything that we want, you know? But also when it's in a compromised state, it is the worst place to be in. And that is the beauty. That's why I would never want to not have gone through this, but also it's, you know, I'm sure at the time you're like, if you had to go through it again tomorrow, would you be like, oh my gosh, please don't make me do that. Yeah. You know, but looking back on it, it was pretty incredible. So for you, I like all of these things started to open up. I know you started in August of 2022. I think what I remember was like, maybe you made a post around like 3 to 4 months, and maybe you were kind of saying pain like was reducing and all those options were opening up, I think, and you can correct me if I'm wrong, but was it like around 6 months or something where you had really done the program, one pass through, maybe you took a little more time, and then was that when you were kind of back to old self?
Yeah. I mean, for me, it's been a progression, you know, cause I'll have members reach out and they'll be like, oh, I'm still in pain. And so for me, I had the mentality, like after I got through the program and I started seeing results, I had this mentality that this is a forever thing in terms of like doing the program and doing these moves. Like, I'm not trying to get to this end point where I'm not doing it anymore. Like, I'm really thinking about it as taking care of my body every day, like kind of like taking a supplement or a vitamin that you take every day. You know what I mean? Brushing your teeth. Like, there's no like end goal where I'm like, okay, I'm not doing this anymore. And I think that mentality really helped, because I've just had so many people reach out and it's like, oh, when did you finish? When did you stop? When did you get to this place? And it's like, with exercise and like with our bodies, like in this society, in our modern day society, like we have to take care of them. You know, there's so many toxins and there's so much stress and pressure and, you know, we have to work. And so it's like, we need to do things every day to take care of ourselves. So for me, it's like, I'm going to just keep doing the program. I'm not trying to get to this end result. So it's kind of hard to say, you know, this is when, you know, I was 100%, like I'm still doing the program and trying to improve, you know, I'm working on my pull-ups, you know.
That's been awesome. That's been awesome to see you actually like go. And I think I remember when you first, you know, I saw some initial videos of pull-ups and maybe you're just working on the eccentrics. Now you're actually going all the way up to the top.
And I'm getting there. I'm getting strong. So yeah, I feel like it definitely took, I would say, 6 months to get rid of like the sciatica and then just continue to get like stronger and be able to do more and more each time I go through the program, you know, each time I do it.
Yeah. Yeah. And I think, you know, that was a realization that I had as well. You know, I think you come in with probably the intention to become pain-free and, you know, then that's going to be the finish line. And then I think a few things. One, I think most people do really eliminate, and I believe that, like, I don't believe that people need to deal with these injuries chronically forever. And I think there is resolution, but also at the same point in time, you're like, hey, for me, for instance, like, I'm pain-free from sciatica. It's been 6 years, so I can actually say that authentically. Yeah. I'm not lying. I'm not putting something out there. But I'm not pain-free in the sense that, like, because I learned all these things with my body, it's given me the confidence to go and get back to training hard. And, you know, I ran a really fast half marathon and, like, I tweaked my hip, you know, and I've tweaked stuff in my body. So like I've had pain, but first off, I think those signals, one, I listen to them. I don't fear them. So they're not nearly as high. I think that's one nice aspect of going through an appropriate healing journey of pain. You can learn how to read new signals and not be so scared of them and intensify them. And then two, obviously, like the proficiency of how I respond to things, I believe, and I see this with our members too, so much faster healing stuff in the future. It's an assumption because you can't really test injury prevention, because if something didn't happen, how can you say that? My guess would be that people probably would prevent future injuries. I think I would say I have, and I think our members probably would, because like if you're starting to feel some sort of pain, you can read it and work with it before it gets worse. So you could prevent injuries. So if you have a really intense experience like you did, there are so many things to be learned if you go through it. But, you know, it's tough because there's a lot of people who might never hop on this path and might kind of go on the other treadmill of medication and all these other things and might just feel like I know a lot of people out there just feel like that's what's in store for them for the rest of their life.
Yeah. Yeah. I feel like I've talked to a lot of people because I'm such a fan, and so many people, their mindset isn't there in terms of beliefs and possibilities. They'll just be like, I'm so glad it worked for you, Sarah, but it won't work for me. And I'm like, yeah, like if that's your mindset going into it, you don't even want to have a conversation about it. And then a lot of people are, they're like, oh, what did you do? Like, send me it. Like, I want to see, I want to check it out, you know? So I think that as we continue to like spread this message and awareness, like more and more people will be open. I think that, you know, the testimonials that you guys share are really powerful because people can see themselves in them and they're like, oh, if she got that, then maybe it's possible for me.
Yeah. And that was a really big idea behind me wanting to actually just start sitting down for an hour. And thank you again for taking, I don't know if I thanked you at the beginning. Thank you for taking time out of your day to share this experience, because I did want to pull it away from a 60-second IG reel where you just see like so-and-so reduced their MRI and got rid of their sciatica and stopped taking pain pills. It's like, no, like maybe that person, but no way. But I think I mean, I've had so many of these conversations. It seems like, but I still love having them because I know there's another person who's feeling the same way that I did and you, but you have these conversations and it really is a lot of the same themes. You know, like when you said, if people say that it's not like great for you, Sarah, but it's not going to work for me, I'm curious about such a loaded question, but like, why do you think so-and-so said that? Or why do you think people say that in general? And I know there's so many different reasons, but.
Yeah. You know, I work as a coach too. And so for me, it's like always kind of digging a little bit deeper. Usually it's a handful of things. I think one is like they've been beaten down so much by the medical system. And so they really lost all hope. And I think one thing that you guys do that's really great is you guys have, I don't know if you guys still offer them, but like these like little series, you know, where it's like a knee series or like a lower back series, you know, because I think that it's like, are you willing to just put that belief on hold just for a little bit, not forever, but could you put it on hold for 5 days and just try this, you know, and see how it goes for you. And then I think once people get a little win and they're like, oh, this actually feels good. And like, I can do this. Then it starts to change, you know, their thought process. And it's like, oh, maybe this will work for me.
That's cool. So did you start with that free 5 day? Do you remember?
Probably. I feel like I listened to the podcast and then I found you guys on Instagram because I was not in that algorithm. You know, I had never, you know, seen anything like that, which is so crazy about Instagram because your guys' videos are great. And I feel like you do such a great job, but like they were not in my realm, which is unfortunate, you know? And so then I found you guys on Instagram and I think I did do that. And then I saw that you guys offered calls and I was like, okay, this is cool. Let me get on a call. And I was just like, oh yeah, this is exactly what I need.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I had a question, but I lost it. I think this is my question. Do you came in with the mindset that you did feel like you could heal? Like, where did that come from for you?
That's such a good question. Before coming, I had done a lot of work on my mindset and kind of my emotions and kind of calming them down because, you know, you go down the medical route and then I'm like, okay, that's not working. So maybe it is like a trauma thing, you know, like I had like some childhood trauma. So I'm like, okay, like, let me like work on my trauma. Let me do therapy. Let me work on my emotions, you know? And so I think I just got to this place where I had done all of this work and I had heard stories, you know, of people healing themselves and just got to a place where it's like, I want to believe that this is possible for me too. Like we are all unique and special, but like healing is possible for everybody. You know, the body knows what to do. I have a lot of education on health, so I know the body can heal itself. So I think just from continuing to work on yourself, and if you work on yourself, like your mindset is going to improve. You start to feel better. You start to see things in a new light. And so, yeah, I think for me, it was just like, I'd read all these stories. I'd done all this work on myself and it felt like this program was the kind of like the missing piece because I didn't have the education around moving my body and exercise that you guys really brought to the table.
Yeah. You know, because I know earlier you mentioned like there being no other option or, you know, having suicidal thoughts and that sort of thing. Right. And I don't know what it's like to walk with that in my headspace. So I won't try to say anything for that situation, but it sounds like you had hope, but then also there were points in time where you're like, I mean, were you giving up on hope? Cause I like when you're having,
you know, so I kind of found you at a good point. I feel like I feel like April really bad, May worse, June worse, July started to go up. Right. I stopped kind of, I was like medical system. Like we're just going to take a little break. Like if I get in a car accident, I'll be calling you, but like, you're not touching my back kind of like space. And then it was like, okay, emotions, you know, trauma, let me work through this. And then it was like, okay. So I kind of had worked through a little bit of that. And I think, you know, one of the main things that really helped me in terms of my mindset and my mental health was to stop telling myself a story about my future and what this means for me and just be in the moment. And that helped a lot because, you know, the pain is one thing, but the suffering that I was putting on myself thinking about, oh, like, you know, I'm not going to be able to travel. I'm not going to be able to have kids. Like, my husband's not going to be with me anymore. Like, all of these things, like all of those stories, that was causing me so much pain in addition to the pain I was physically feeling. And so I had kind of worked through that when I got on a call with you. And so I feel like it just lined up really well.
Yeah, that's awesome. I think, yeah, someone the other day was talking about how he just signed the divorce papers because it's been, you know, 3 years of pain. And I can see how, you know, I just got engaged, but I can see, like, if I had to put myself back in that situation and not know, like, and have to deal with it for a longer time than I had to, like, I could see how strenuous that would be. So sounds like too, your husband, from what I've seen, is just the best, you know, like,
oh, man. He's a winner. He is A plus, like, oh man. Yeah. I really lucked out with him for sure.
Yeah. And, you know, he did the program with you. And that was another thing as well that I chatted about with our last member, Alessia. She was talking about how it was really difficult for her, but she had her boyfriend, I think, at the time, would do the workouts with him. So I think that's another thing. Obviously, it doesn't have to be done alone. Hopefully, you find yourself an incredible partner that's going to stick through the horrible times of pain. But I think that is the other, you know, important piece about community. Do you have any? And also, you don't have to talk to our members or like talk to random people on Instagram. So thank you for doing that too. seriously, because again, that's all people want is to like, yeah, sure. Maybe they want to talk to a co-founder at Wealth, but I'm sure they also really want to talk to someone who did the program. Because I think you are more relatable in that sense to people.
I think that we do this thing and I run programs too. So I get it where we think, oh, it works for them. They created it. They are more knowledgeable than me, you know? And so then to be able to talk to a student of the program where it's like, oh, Sarah has no background in, you know, exercise, nothing like this. She just did the program and got results. It's like, okay, I want to hear from her. What was it really like for her? And I get it. And I honestly like don't mind. And I think that that's something that people can't see from the outside is your guys' community and everybody is wanting to help one another. You know, like so many people when I joined and was like, hey, you know, I'm doing these moves and I'm still experiencing pain. What should I do? They're like DMing me. They're sending me videos. You know, they're asking how I'm doing. They're telling me to post my exercises. You know what I mean? And so it's like they did that for me. Like I'm going to do it for them too.
When you saw that coming in though, why do you think people are doing that? Again, loaded question, a lot of reasons, obviously, but do you?
I think it's you guys. I think it's how you set up the program. Like I work as a coach myself. I've been in lots of communities. I build communities. And I think that, you know, I see you and Andrew talk a lot about you guys got to post. You got to post your exercises. You got to post what you're doing. You know what I mean? So I think that you guys have really set up this safe environment where people feel comfortable being vulnerable and sharing. And then everybody is going through it or has been there before. And so we can all relate and we know how terrible it feels like. And we want to help others.
Yeah. We just want to help others. And like, you know, we've had someone the other day just posted and she was like, I'm overweight and I'm happy with my body. And like Wealth was always a safe space to do that. I know there are people like, and I've been overweight at certain points in my life. Like that's not a fun thing to deal with if you're not happy with it. I know a lot of people are not happy with being overweight. So like, I can only imagine that that could be difficult or intimidating to not only be in pain, but not be happy with how your body works or looks. I think a lot of people in pain are not happy with how their body looks simply because like you haven't been able to use it how you want to. So I think, you know, of course that affects body composition. You're dealing with physical pain and then mental or, you know, physical looks that you want to change. And then mentally, it's all just this, you know, whole shit storm up there. And that is why we have set up the community in the way in which it's like, hey, no one's here to judge you. Like, let's get some stuff down. We'll coach you on the videos. We'll coach you on form feedback. We'll answer your questions. We're just going to support you, you know, and it's, that is really cool to see different body types and levels of experience. People come in who are intimidated and not comfortable, and then they develop a passion or new strength or new beliefs about themselves through something that was so traumatic.
Yeah. No, it's really cool to see. You see like all different body types, and you see like people from different countries, which is cool. Some people at home, some people at the gym. I know sometimes like for us, we just moved to Mexico and, you know, we weren't able to bring all of our equipment with us. And so sometimes I like to see like how other people are like doing the moves, you know, like right. with like Nordic curls, you know, I was like, oh, like, I think somebody like made something, Peter, maybe you can make it, like, look at this, you know? Yeah. And so it's like, yeah, nobody really cares about what your body looks like. It's more so just like doing the moves and getting them right and getting out of pain. It's
yeah. Cool. Oh my gosh. That's awesome.
Yeah.
I got to go hop on a call in a few minutes, but I have one last question for you. If you were to just like tell yourself something about how to proceed through, you know, pain, like talking back to yourself, or, you know, ideally there's people who are listening to this right now who are dealing with, you know, sciatica or disc herniation. They've tried, you know, a few things. Like, what would be a piece of advice that you have for them or yourself listening back?
Yeah, I would say try mobility. It's been so powerful for me. Like, get in a program like Limitless Wealth and like trust the program, trust the process. Like, you are special, but like, you're not different. Like, if it can work for other people, like, there's no reason why it can't work for you. I think that this program is so powerful, and I just hope more people find it.
Yeah. Thank you. That is another thing I tell people. I'm like, I know we all want to feel like we're special. You're very special at the same point in time. Like, a lot of these incredible stories, like, Sarah, you're very special. And then if I'm going to talk to someone else, I'm like, hey, Sarah's not any more special than you if you're able to kind of replicate the non-special but special things. Like, of course, you have to have belief in yourself and stop telling yourself the stories that'll never get better. You have to part ways with some of the aspects of the diagnosis. I would say the most special thing, though, is that you were just able to consistently show up for yourself. And that is special because we kind of look around at the state of affairs with health. And, you know, that is a special characteristic that people possess. But other than that, you know, it's like, hey, if we're able to focus and dial in on our day-to-day movements and other, you know, lifestyle habits that Wealth goes through, and I really hope a lot of other programs go through, because right now we don't have enough of a reach to change the entire state of affairs for, you know, back pain and any sort of pain. I hope other programs are doing that. But if you can start to understand that your body is capable of those changes, if you put in that work, then, you know, other people aren't more special than you.
Yeah. I think like you guys have a really great program. I mean, that's why I talk about it. It's like, work the program. The program does work. If you work it, like, it will work. And like, if you have issues, you got to ask for help. I think that's another thing, is people are afraid to ask for help. It's like, if something isn't working for you, like, ask. There are so many people that know what they're doing and that are willing to help you, especially like in your guys' community. So I think that's really cool too.
Yeah. Were you ever afraid to ask for help as you're going through the program?
That's not really my style. Like, okay. I'm like, I think some people are, but I just find, for me, like, I think it's something that's built in, where it's like, I need help, and like, I have no qualms about saying, like, I don't know what I'm doing, but like, I'm going to find out someone who does, you know?
For sure. Yeah. Like, okay, if other people are intimidated about asking for help, I'll go straight to the front of the line and I'll get the help that I want.
100%. And like, I'll ask for help for you too, you know? So if you're afraid to ask, like, I'll post your question for you.
For sure.
I think too, like, with Facebook groups, you can post anonymously which I feel like, I think that there's something there too. I teach my clients this, where it's like, we got to work through like, what is that block, you know, that fear of being seen, because you can only get so far.
Right.
Like, hiding behind, you know, whatever it is. So
yeah, you know, that's another thing. Like, I have heard people use this as an excuse, you know, if you want to talk about the government spying, whatever, people are like, I won't go on Facebook, this and that. You know, maybe some people really are that's why they don't like Facebook. But I think most people who are like, I don't want to join the Facebook group, they don't want to put themselves out there because they're like, eh, is this community going to judge me? Or like, am I really going to publicly commit to the wealth team or community? Or just even by doing this, am I open to publicly committing that I'm starting my rehab process and this is a first step? Which I think if you know that and you're scared about that, that's one piece of advice that I had to people is like, hey, corner yourself in a room and like put it out there. Like, hey, I'm so-and-so from so, and you know, wherever. I have a disc herniation and I'm joining wealth to do X, Y, Z. Like put out those goals out in the world so that you can start being accountable to someone or something for maybe the first time in a while.
Yeah. I mean, I believe in manifestation too. So I feel like put out like what you want to happen, you know, like if you want to do the program, like say you signed up and like, you're going to do the program. And I think a lot of people are afraid that what if I say this and then I don't do that. Right. Mm-hmm. But then we're playing the what if game.
Yeah.
What if you say it and you actually do it?
Yeah, for sure. Yeah. People will be like, well, what if I had someone say that the other day, all these anecdotes of someone being like, she was like, I'm traveling and I don't want to tell you that I'm going to do the movements in case I don't. I was like, oh man, we're dealing with a decade of chronic pain. Like we got to figure out how to work through this. But again, I have, you know, a lot of empathy, sympathy. I know those words get interchanged for that tough situation, but I got to run. Thank you so much for spending over an hour of your time sharing that. And I'm looking forward to chatting with you tomorrow.
Same. I hope that this helps.
Okay. All right, Sarah. All right. Take care. All right. I'll see you tomorrow. Cameron. Bye.